Hello everyone, thanks for joining me in the talk. Today we are going to talk about software L4 load balancing for Kubernetes service at Yahoo. I'm Karthikeyan Kangaraj, I'm a production engineer at Yahoo, focusing on modernizing Yahoo tech stack in a cloud native way. Let's get started by taking a look at Kubernetes scale at Yahoo. Overall, we have 2,400 plus applications in 34 production clusters across 7 data centers. Our ingress stack handles 2 million peak RPS. This is the screenshot from our Prometheus presentation showing the number of nodes and pods and applications that we run across the board. We wanted to solve the traditional hardware load balancer problem where the servers are pre-configured with the hardware load balancer and any changes to the servers need a configuration push. LB APIs are not optimized for the dynamic updates, so automatically adding a servers in a web is not possible. Of course, auto-scaling is not possible. If you want to scale a service behind a web, we need to add the service manually. Another problem we wanted to solve is performance degradation with large number of test services. As we all know that Qproxy is IP table based, it generates long list of IP tables rules. Packet has to enumerate through long list of IP table rules to locate service on the pods. This introduces performance degradation. This is a very nice blog post shows how the performance got degraded while accessing the first services to the last services in a cluster of 50,000 services. Why we choose Selenium as a software L4LB? Commodity hardware can be deployed as a software L4LB. With this, scaling the LB is as simple as adding the service. With XDP, performance is at par with hardware LB, so there is no compromise on the performance. As Selenium is hooked directly into the Kubernetes API, any changes to the backend pod get updated to the L4LB instantaneously. Selenium L4LB makes the same decision across the board, so any packet part of a connection can be routed to any LB. It also supports DSR mode, which makes us no difference with the hardware LB. With Maglo consistent hashing, Selenium makes a highly available and reliable software load balancer. Let me walk you through how the traffic gets routed to the application pod through Selenium LB with an example. Let's say we have an application deployment with three replicas and a service with an external IP 2.2.2.2. This IP is a web IP, and in our case, it's an Anycast IP as well. And with Anycast IP, many Selenium LB nodes are responsible for it. The traffic to the many Selenium LB nodes are load balanced through ECMP. When a client sends a request to 2.2.2.2, the request lands on one of the Selenium LB nodes. As the Selenium LB nodes are directly to the Kubernetes API, it knows about the backend pods where to route. With Maglo consistent hashing, it picks a pod and then forwards the packet to the pod. And the Selenium agent on the node where the pod is running helps to redirect the traffic back to the client. In our setup, we run Bird as a daemon. Bird helps in advertising the routes of the web to the network. And also it helps to establish a BFT session with the tar. BFT is bidirectional forward detection. This helps to detect the network failure in the forwarding path. BFT works by exchanging the control packets between the two network devices. When there is a timeout between the control packets, then that particular path is considered as a failure. In our setup, we have configured 15 milliseconds for the one control packet exchange, and we have set three retries. So with the 150 milliseconds, a particular node and the network is failed, it can able to detect it and then can able to take it out of production automatically. If the BFT session is broken in the tar considers the network path for the LB node is failing, and the tar helps in announcing the new routes to the network, and then the network will not route the traffic to this L4LB node. Hence, it is taken out of production automatically. So in our setup, a particular LB node on a failure case can able to go out of production automatically in 150 milliseconds. Okay. This diagram represents our data center network topology. See in the picture, server and the rack connected to the tar, and the tars are connected to the leaf, and leaf is connected to the spine. So we run spine leaf architecture in the data center, and all the devices are enabled with ECMP. ECMP helps to load balance the incoming traffic across multiple load balancer nodes. Traffic from the internet enters through the data center through the spine, and the spine is can able to do an ECMP and send the traffic to the L4LB node. And the L4LB node with XDP can able to redirect the packets to the corresponding pod, and the pod gives the response back to the client directly and the request served to the client. We did an extensive performance test to make sure that traffic routed through the Selenium LB doesn't have a performance overhead. We did a number of tests, and one of the sample test results is shown on the table. We observed only a small latency overhead in microseconds when traffic is routed through the Selenium LB, and this is in par with hardware load balancer. And we are just starting with Cilium, and we are deployed across two data centers, and one production application is routed through the Describe solution. And we are expediting to move every workload to the Cilium LB solution in Q3, Q4. And with this, I'm concluding. Thank you so much for listening to the talk. Please post your questions in the Slack. Thank you.